What's going on? I'm Marcus, and you're at the channel of the Debt-Free Dad. In today's video, we're going to talk about something I haven't talked about in a while. We're going to talk about student loans because there's some more information out there. So we're going to talk a little bit about student loan forgiveness, student loan forbearance. Will it get extended? What's going on? Who lied and made a bunch of political promises? Who doing what? So, as always, before we jump in, if you're interested in following my debt-free journey and learning about finance, I invite you to subscribe to the channel, hit the like button and the notification bell below because it'll help the channel grow and help this video reach more people. So, before we talk about student loans, I got a few things to say before we delve in. First and foremost, I know that there's going to be one person who watches this video and just going to go on a rant in the comments about how us liberals want everybody to pay for everything. This is to whoever that person is. Actually watch all of my student loan videos where I'm actually paying my student loans, but I don't know why it is, but some people are like, oh man, if you didn't have it, I don't want y'all to get it. Nobody paid my student loans. I paid for college when it was $35 back in 1921, and you should be able to pay for yours too. Who cares? This is not one of those videos, okay? I'm paying my student loans. I don't really care what anybody else is doing. I don't care what the government say they are or aren't going to do. The only money the government got is the money they take for the taxpayers. But I already know it's going to be one of y'all out there who just going to watch half the video or watch the title and just go on some rant in the comments. So this is for you. Actually watch the other videos, whoever you are, because I'm talking to you because I know it's going to happen. That's number one. Number two, I do want to talk just a little bit about something that's non-student loan related, but it is finance related. Now, I know the demographics of the people who watch this channel, the age bracket, the men versus the women. So, how many of you all have what I like to refer to as a SSF? The last two letters are SF, so it clearly stands for sinking fund. Right, so this is just straight adult talk, okay? Because somebody I was talking to about this said, man, I don't know if you should put that on your channel, but this is 100% real talk to all the parents out there, the folks who are married with kids, the people who have kids, but I like to refer to it as a sexcation sinking fund. Now, let me explain to you, for those of you who don't know, this is what a sexcation sinking fund is. When you are married or in a relationship or with your significant other and you got kids in the house, hey, sometimes you want to get the hell away from the kids. And I don't know what it is about your sexcation when you actually decide to have one, but it makes things like 50,000 times more amazing. I don't know if it's because you're not at home in a hotel or the kids aren't there. You don't got to worry about stepping on toys or the dog. So I'm officially starting a sexcation sinking fund. I don't know if that's going to be a challenge, but it's something that I'm doing because I like to have sexcations every now and then. So I just wanted to get that out. Now, enough of all this SSF talk and of all the complaining guys who are talking about the government shouldn't pay for student loans. Y'all are annoying. Let's jump into the videos and talk about student loans, what's going on with the forgiveness, what's going on with the forbearance, and I'll give a little bit about my opinion as to what I think will happen. So far, hey, I've been okay. I knew they was going to extend things. So far, so good. Let's talk about it. President Biden will not include any student loan cancellation in his annual budget. Essentially what happens, Congress develops a budget that they work to kind of approve that comes up through the House and the Senate, and the President also has a budget that he creates. Then they take those two budgets and they beef, they negotiate, they figure out what they're going to cut, what they're going to supplement, and then they work on one collective budget that everyone can agree on. That's generally how the process goes. There are some other things such as reconciliation that I talked about in other videos, but I'm not really going to go into that one. But so far what we are, President Biden hasn't included anything related to student loan cancellation in his actual stimulus plan. Ooh, big shocker. I think that's something that we were easily able to anticipate. No one is really surprised by that. One thing that the President did do, he did ask the Secretary of Education along with the Department of Justice to issue him a memo that examines his presidential authority to cancel student loan debt through an executive order. Now, again, as I always say, I'm an attorney, I'm a licensed attorney, but I'm not your attorney. According to my reading of the Higher Education Act, I think it's relatively clear that the president and the Secretary of Education does have the authority to cancel student loan debt. And essentially he has that authority through an executive order. So it's going to be interesting to see what that memo says. I will tell you, a lot of times, and you've seen this quite often, I've worked for judges at federal levels, at state supreme courts, and various levels of the government. And sometimes when opinions are written on the legal concept or can you do this or can you do that, some people, they want you to write up the opinion based on what their belief is. So I wouldn't be shocked if an opinion came from DOJ and the Department of Education that stated that the president does not have the authority, just because that's probably where he wants the decision to go. So it's not uncommon. So it's really going to be interesting to see how it plays out. They're either going to write it unilaterally without the influence of the president, which I seriously doubt, or they're going to write the opinion consistent with what the president believes. And if DOJ writes it, that will be what is the law of the land, so to speak. So it's going to be interesting to see how it plays out. And the other reason that I don't anticipate that DOJ will come out with guidance that he does have the authority is because Biden has been clear from the beginning that he wanted to call on Congress to actually do student loan cancellation of the $10,000 that he agreed on. So what's probably going to happen is Congress won't come to a conclusion of $10,000, or an alternative, once the midterm elections come up in a little while, what will likely happen, because, you know, Republicans, hey, kudos to them on their gamesmanship. Policy aside, their gamesmanship is what it is, but they know how to play the game very well. What will likely happen is Biden calls on Congress to cancel the $10,000. Congress can't come to an agreement, but during the midterm elections, you'll likely see the other side of Republicans start to speak more about student loan cancellation, because student loan cancellation is just one of those chips that is used when you want to sell wolf tickets and get people to buy in. So that's really where we are with student loan cancellation. So far, there's nothing in the president's budget. It's going to be solely up to Congress. He has DOJ and the Department of Education working on a memo to examine the scope of his authority to cancel student loans through an executive order. That's it. Now, I think the bigger concern, or the bigger thing that, you know, could help a lot of people, is what's going to go on with the student loan forbearance and interest freeze. Now, as it sets, that is set to expire on September 30th, so payments will resume on October 1st. Now, this is quite interesting, because there have been communications amongst the president's staff, you can Google it and find it at open source research, that said that President Biden is not opposed to potentially extending the student loan forbearance and interest rate freeze past September 30th. So that could be something that could provide a lot of persons who have student loans debt a lot of relief. But one of the things that he's going to condition this decision on will be based on where the United States economy is. So essentially, closer to the September date, it'll probably be in June or July, the executive branch will probably take a look at the economy, the jobs report, the stock market, just to kind of see how things are progressing, how the pandemic is playing out. If the numbers continue to go down, if the jobs report continues to improve, well, I'm not going to say continue, because, the last one I think was good, but the few before that have been terrible. But if the overall health of the economy is trending upward and the coronavirus pandemic is trending downward, it's in all likelihood that a student loan forbearance and extension on the interest rate freeze won't move forward. That's what a lot of the pundits and the media outlets are planning. Now, I will tell you, I actually have a different view of this, and this is just my opinion. I don't have a word to the street as to the student loan stuff, but this is just my opinion. I think that as September 30th roll around, I think that it's actually likely that the student loan forbearance and interest rate freeze will get extended. Now, this is why midterm elections are going to be coming up. I don't think that anything is going to get done on student loan cancellation. It damn sure won't be a $50,000 cancellation. Biden's not going to do a $10,000 cancellation. I don't think Congress is going to get it done because they have a lot of other stuff that they're working on. And really, a $10,000 student loan cancellation is definitely probably not on their list of high priority items. But I do think that the Biden administration, the executive branch, will try to split the difference to try to find some middle ground. And I think the middle ground would be to extend that student loan forbearance and interest rate freeze, because they aren't going to get any relief, even though the Democratic Party has been saying relief, relief, relief. Biden talked about relief. Nobody came out and did anything. So I think it'll be politically a smart move to actually extend the student loan forbearance, the student loan interest rate freeze. I'm not sure how long they would extend it to, but if I had to anticipate, I think they would just extend it all the way through the end of this calendar year to have payments resume in January. I think just as a general idea, it's always good to kind of, hey, if you're going to suspend payments, let's go ahead and get everybody through that holiday season, September, October, November, December, and go into the new year. So I actually feel relatively optimistic. Now, I will tell you again, I don't have my ear to the ground. I have been right before, though, the last time the extension was coming around. I kind of anticipated that. So I think it is going to get extended again. I think it'll likely be just until the end of this calendar year. And I think that it'll be done just because they haven't done anything else with student loan relief. And I think this extension will be a way to essentially not have too many voters get lost from empty promises that people made. So that's kind of where it is. That's where we are with regard to student loans. As I hear information, of course, I'll give you an update, but that's where we are. So enjoy the forbearance and the interest rate freeze while you can. That's what I'm doing. That's what I'm trying to capitalize on. I will tell you what my plan is whenever the student loan forbearance and interest rate freeze come to an end. I'm essentially going to refinance my student loans to get a much lower interest rate. Right now, there are places out there that are offering interest rates of 3% and 2%. I think, you know, generally the general numbers with regard to federal student loans is between 5 to 7%. If you can refinance and get a 2% interest rate on your student loan, I think that would be very advantageous, especially if you want to take advantage and pay it off aggressively. And that's what I'm doing, so that'll probably be my game plan. I just want everyone to know one thing to consider when you refinance your student loans, you do lose some of the potential protections or benefits you can get as a federal student loan. For example, let's say that the President and Congress did decide to forgive $10,000 in student loans 18 months from now. Well, if you refinance that student loan at 2% interest rate through a private lender, you won't be able to take advantage of that $10,000 forgiveness. To me, I don't think it make a difference because I just don't think that forgiveness is going to happen. I've seen them talk about this every presidential cycle for the past two or three presidents. So to me, I think it's probably more advantageous to get a much lower interest rate if you can. But just remember, if you do refinance with a private institution, in the event that forgiveness does come about or any other type of federal program, it may not apply to your student loan. So that's something that you'll have to think about. I appreciate you as always tuning in. Hey, y'all have a good one. Be blessed. Check out the two videos that's popping up. And if you haven't, hit that subscribe button right here in the middle so you can get more of this content. Y'all be blessed. Peace.